If you run a business or planning to start running one, there might be a simple way to grow your customer base. Stay tuned to find out more about how to grow your customer base in a simple way.
Crypto Media Service, bringing you in-depth thoughts on cryptocurrencies.
Welcome to Crypto Media Service. I'm the Golden Boy. I'll be your host today, where we're going to be talking about payment solutions. And if you run a business or have tried to start a business, you know that payment solutions are not cheap, and it is sometimes a little bit difficult to set up, even with tech support. But we are going to be showing you a way to set up an easy payment solution, a payment wall of sorts with cryptocurrencies. And it's a way for you to grow your customer base. So, let's dive into it. There are several solutions out there, such as Coinbase, BitPay, coinpayments. And we will be focusing on coinpayments, which are the best solution for both physical stores and online stores. If you're interested in any of the other solutions, I have linked to an article down below. But why do we recommend coin payments? Well, it's quite simply because it's a solution that gives you the most coins to accept, automatic exchange so you get the coin you want, even automatic exchange into your local currency. So you only need to set it up. Once it's set up, it's simple to use. The setup process can be a little difficult, but there are a good guide on how to do it. There are several reasons why to accept cryptocurrency. Let's first take the solution, look at it. Afterwards, we can talk about the type of customer you will be able to attract by accepting cryptocurrencies. Before we start diving into coin payments, let's just talk a little bit about what they do accept and what prices they take. They accept over 760 different altcoins, which gives you a wide array of altcoins to accept and to exchange for your local currency so you can buy a new product. They are also only charging 0.5% for every transaction. It is not a lot. I have recently consulted on a payment solution from another big provider. They were charging 1.5% of the transaction up to a certain amount. So it can be cheaper than a credit card, but you can also attract a new type of customer with accepting cryptocurrency. And some of the currencies can be set to auto exchange. When you look over their list of accepted currencies, you will see a little green icon which says convert. This icon means that it can auto-convert into different currencies and auto-convert into fiat currency. The fiat solution I have not tried because I like to manage it myself, and therefore I have not tried it out in any way. But all the other part of the solution I have actually tried out and works extremely well. And of course they accept the major currencies which are being adopted around the cryptocurrency space, so you do not need to fear that you cannot accept the major currencies. With that in mind, let's see if they have any integration into other shopping cart products. And of course they got that. They got integration with Shopify, Magneto, WooCommerce, OpenCart, and so on, with even more products on their page. This gives you a great integration option if you got any of the shopping carts they use. And this integration makes it a lot easier to, well, accept cryptocurrency. One of the places I have consulted with only use their quick point of sale system. They have a normal register, and then on their tablet, they use this quick point of sale system where they will hit whatever currency they think they need. Let's just take US dollar, no, euro, sorry. We say 500 euro. We have been charging the customer, we move on and say continue. We can choose the coin we want. We can take Dogecoin, for example, which will be 252,944.2287.9 Doge. We can also take Bitcoin, Litecoin. These are the coins I have set up to use in my test store. We also have Etherium, which is also one of the big ones. All of these coins will automatically exchange inside coin payments solution to the coin I have chosen. And when we say complete the payment, we will just make it, get it to make a code. On this one, it has 24 hours to pay. Some of the coins have 2 hours, some of them have 1 hour. It all depends on, well, the network, how fast is the network, and so on. And all your customer has to do is take their mobile phone with their wallet on, scan the address with this QR code, and you will receive the funds. You will be able to follow the funds if they need to pay from, let's say, 5 different wallets. You are able to see that, oh, now the one wallet has paid, now the second and third, and until it's up on the right amount. It is your customer's responsibility to make sure the payment goes through. It is not your responsibility. You just provide them with the code. If they got them all in one wallet, they can actually pay it directly from that one wallet, and you will receive a first unconfirmed, but everything has been paid, and after an amount of blocks, depending on the currency, you will receive a confirmation. On some currencies, there might be a long confirmation time. And if it's small money, well, I have consulted a pizzeria on this. And if they are below 100 Danish crowns, which is around 15 to 20 euros, I believe, then they will just accept it when once it is still unconfirmed. If they go below, above the 100 Danish crowns, well, they will wait until the first confirmation. Above 1,000, they will wait until the 16th confirmation. So, in that way, they try to make it easy for the customer, but also secure themselves. As you can see, there's also the pay by name, redeem a coupon code, or purchase by name tag. In your account, you also have transaction history, coin settings, wallets, and you have a merchant tool. From the merchant tool, let's just blow it up, you have the shopping cart plugins, where you can see all the plugins available. And as you can see, there are quite a few shopping cart plugins. Some of them are not original. You have to make sure about that, read about it. You have the API, which can integrate. You have the invoice builder. From here, you can build an invoice and send it to your customer. You have the point of sale, the HTML URL field guide, here you have the point of sales link generator, so you can just generate a QR code. If you have, let's say, only things to $10, you can actually make one simple QR code and just keep on following that. You have the button maker, the HTML post fields. Yeah, let's go in. We can make the buttons here. We can say, oh, this is our merchant ID. The item names, we can say donation. $10. Item description is not required. The only thing down here is required is the image. Multiple cryptocurrency accepted via coin payments. Or pay using coin payment. Yeah, pay using. And they have a lot of different styles you can choose, which is quite good. They also got donations buttons, and shopping cart button, and advanced button maker, and they got a lot of tools here. And if you're not that big into all these kind of tools that just make the here, crypto media service, $10. We have no item number, we have no invoice number, we have no tax amount. We do not need to collect shipping address if we are just making donations. We just want to make them private. We do not need a shipping address. We can make an URL. We can say HTTP. Oh, and we will say cryptsums.online, and this is where we also will set and cancel URLs. IPN URL, we have none. And then we want to make this big button so you can see, hey, you can donate via coin payment. We can then generate the button, and down here below we have the form. And let's jump over to a site where I can use the form. I cannot use the form on cryptums.online simply because it will not work with the program I'm using to make the website. So I will jump over to cryptums.net, which is our gaming website, so and show you how it works. Now we are over at cryptums.net, which is our gaming website, and I have put the button down here in the bottom of the site. And we will, once we push it, we get into this site. On this site, you can choose to enter first and last name. Let's just say send none. And I want to change this to $100. Recalculate. And I want to pay them in Bitcoin, Litecoin. And we have it here. Complete donation. Now we have to wait, and the customer can donate. It functions quite the same way with the shopping cart, just that you cannot change the amount. If I now scan it with my app, it will give me a confirmation that I have donated. And it is the same thing with the payment solutions. And this makes it quite simple to use for you and for your customer in the online stores. And I've shown you the point of sales system. And the API can integrate with some registers that I have not tried yet. I am still getting my programmer to look at it and making it work. So it requires a lot of technical knowledge. But even if you don't have the technical knowledge, you still have a lot of availability for this product. Down below, you will find a link to coin payments. I will urge you to use that link if you're trying to set up coin payments, because, well, it will support me if you get any transactions without you noticing it. And what I mean by that is they don't take any money from you. They take it from the fee they would take normally. So you pay the same fee and you support me just by registering with my code, without you paying anything extra. And since this has, well, drawn out a little bit, the next time I will be talking about what type of customer you can attract using cryptocurrency, because there are many types of customers you don't know about or you don't think about. And I want to thank you for watching this episode. As always, remember to click like, subscribe, and that little bell notification icon so you get notified every time we get a new video online. I will thank you for watching in and hope you have a great time. Until next week, bye bye.